acting normal.
It fell over in front of us. I think it's had something, it's had a treatment. It's probably a nice bit.
Stylish building, eh? The museum itself, it's it was designed by a local architect in Nairobi in conjunction with some people from the TARA, Trust of African Rock Art, which is a sort of society, which they look after the sites of African rock art, not just in Kenya, all over the African continent. And they are trying to make a map of the flow of peoples, earlier peoples, how they moved, and they can trace what they were doing in certain sites because of the documentation on the rocks, as in art. And sometimes these were showing somebody's wealth, number of cattle, or how many people traveled across in a canoe, how many strokes and how many circles there were, I believe was more of a record of how many boats had come and who had survived, etc., etc. When they were chased from Uganda, they must have come here, and they must have had little or no tools or equipment. They must have just started from scratch, really.
This particular key we were given when I was in Robben Island as a for prison key gate for Mandela, and
a replica.
It's a replica key, and we were given as a symbol that we come back and open the heritage of our communities, and that's what we are doing here in Suba. When we came back, we started opening, going to talking with the elders, getting awareness to the community towards the value of their heritage.
Okay, welcome Mfangano. This is Mfangano village, Suba district. So you are highly welcome in Mfangano. I'm Charles Odhiambo. This is my home area, and I'm very happy to welcome my visitors in Mfangano. And I want them to be free in everything you like, and I'm very thankful God was giving me this opportunity to talk or tell you about the Mfangano. Mfangano is a very big island, and contains so many people inside, about 500 people. And we have so many schools in the island, and we have rock paints, and we have the museum and the beach hotels in Mfangano, and everything there in Mfangano. And we do some farming and some fishing, and in fact we are ready to implement so many things in Mfangano so that visitors can come and view, go and see how Mfangano looks like. And we have so many islands there, bordering Uganda and Kenya near us here. We have Remba Highland, we have Dingo Highland, and we have Rigiti Highland, and we have Mbasa Highlands where birds are. Yeah, we have so many birds and elephants. This is my home area in Lake Victoria.
This is the real tropical forest. I wish you brought Jenna and Kate here. This is the real one.
It's a real tropical forest in Mfangano. It's in Lake Victoria. Look at the place, it's wild, it's full of nature, full of life. All visitors should come and see here. If you love nature, you should come and visit this place. On the other side is Lake Victoria, it's just nice waves, cool, calm. The temperature is very good, it's very nice here. Look at the hills, very cool. So people should come and see this place, just for a sight.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you? How are you doing? Man, this island is crazy. Yeah, the sounds crazy. Crazy nice. Yeah, I'm loving it. I'd live here forever. Right now we are at our friend's place in a tent. He offered us a trip to his home. So he pitched a tent for us because his home is not very big, so we couldn't fit in all of us. So we pitched a tent outside his place. But it's great, the sound, the peace, so much life, the insects, sounds outside. Yeah? It's very nice. And at the background, you can feel the ocean. You can feel the sea just flowing. It's a cool place, really cool.
Made in Scotland, mate. Fucking all things made to. I've got to get the name of the company. It's on the side of the girder here, but you can't read it properly because it's in the shade. It's in the shadow. Ian somebody, Steel Company Limited, Scotland. Scotland the Brave.